Thank you very much for the very kind introduction. Hello, everybody. Today, I'm going to talk about science of cracks. And I will introduce you a new concept, which is called paradynamics. So I'm a structural engineer. And as a structural engineer, we can consider ourselves as doctors of structures. And when you think about structure, it can be anything that you can imagine. It can be a ship, it can be airplane, or even our bodies. And when these structures are subjected to external loading, they start deforming. As they deform, their stress level increases, and the structure starts feeling uncomfortable, like ourselves. If we are loaded with too much stress, we feel uncomfortable as well. And if the stress level in the structure increases too much, it fails as a result of cracks. So by using paradynamics, we can predict these cracks. It's such a method that we can predict all these failures. Just like medical doctors, if you are very stressed, if you are under too much pressure, you go to a doctor, they can help you. Similarly, by using paradynamics, we can try to help any type of structures to prevent from failure. In order to understand paradynamics, we need to look at two concepts, cracks and local, non-local behavior. Although we don't realize, cracks are actually part of our lives. And in most of the cases, cracks are the things that we don't want them to happen. Think about it. You buy a brand new cell phone and you drop it on the floor and you will have cracks. And it will be really annoying to use such a cell phone because of these cracks. Or you have a nice teacup. You wash it with very hot water. And then you decide to drink cold water with that hot cup. And by the time you put hot water in the cold water in the cup, you will have crack. This is my cup, by the way. I just take a picture of it. I think it looks very nice. But sometimes, actually, we want to have cracks. For example, if you want to enjoy a chocolate bar. Here's a chocolate bar. First thing you need to do, you need to open the package. To open the package, you need to tear it by creating a crack. Okay, you open the package. You take the chocolate bar out. Then the next thing you need to do, you need to eat it by cutting it into smaller pieces. I'm not going to eat it, by the way. So you need to create lots of cracks in order to enjoy it. Otherwise, you cannot enjoy it. You cannot just put all the chocolate bar into your mouth. So cracks can be fun things too. So as engineers, we need to answer the question, when and why the cracks will start and how they will propagate. In old days, people were using theoretical calculations. By using these hand calculations, they were trying to find out for simple crack problems. But as you can imagine, it is very limited. But today we have computers. We can use computer simulations for these sophisticated crack problems. For example, if you are interested, what happens a bullet hits an armor material? Because this is very important for the safety of our soldiers so that we can design more protective materials. Or if you're interested, what happens if a missile hits a concrete material? Here the simulation. You can simulate them by using computers and paradynamics. And you can take necessary actions. Here I'll show you some example. I have a plate. It has two vertical cracks. And I'm hitting it with a hammer. Can you guess how the cracks will propagate? Please raise your hand if you think the cracks will propagate in the vertical direction. Okay. Who thinks the cracks will propagate in the horizontal direction? Okay. How about with an angle? Okay. So it's not easy to guess. But let's see what happens. It propagates with an angle. So, by using computers, by using paradynamic simulations, it's such a method that we can predict what happens when we hit it with in a structure. There are also other methods which can do these similar calculations. We call them traditional methods. And the Feynman-Thielemann method is the most common one. In order to better understand the difference between traditional methods and paradynamics, we need to look at local and non-local concepts. So local concept was defined long time ago by Aristotle. He said that in order to move an object, you have to push it. Although that's correct, it's not complete. Today, we know that objects that are far from each other can still interact with each other. Let me show you an example. Here is the ball. You see, the ball is far from the ground, but because of this non-local interaction, it falls on the ground. We call this non-local behavior, and paradynamics is based on this non-local concept. The word paradynamics coming from Greek language. Peri means surrounding, which represents the range of interactions between different objects. And force means dynamics, which represents the force between interacting objects. And I'll show you some examples how we use paradynamics for failure prediction. So electronic companies realized that during the soldering process, the electronic packages were cracking with a popcorn sound. And we investigated the reason. What is the reason behind this? And we find out that the electronic packages involve polymer component. And during the shipping or storage, this polymer component absorbs moisture. And during the soldering process, when we are trying to combine different electronic components together, the moisture inside the package becomes a vapor. And it creates vapor pressure and it creates crack. And you can see on the top the failure in an electronic package. By using paradynamics, we were able to simulate the whole cracking process, as you can see here. And it is very similar to what is seen in the real life. Actually, this process is very similar to popcorn crack. The popcorn, I don't know if you know, but the popcorn has a very strong waterproof shell. And it has a moisture in it. Let's say if you want to make popcorn at your home, what you do, you heat the popcorn. As the seed gets heated, the temperature rises and the moisture inside the seed becomes vapor and it creates vapor pressure and it creates these nice popcorns that we enjoy. So the seed turns into popcorn. By using this idea, by using paradynamics, we were able to understand what is happening in the electronic packages. Another problem that we investigate is the corrosion. Metals can really suffer from corrosion if you don't take necessary actions. And today, we spend lots of money for corrosion prevention. Therefore, we need materials that are resistant to corrosion environment. Any improvement on the corrosion characteristic of the metal will bring us significant benefits. By using paradynamics, we were able to simulate how the corrosion starts, how it evolves. And you can see the corrosion pits generated by this damage. And we can also predict how the cracks will initiate from these corroded regions. This will be also very helpful for us for designing corrosion-resistant materials in the future. We also look at extreme loading cases. We investigate what happens if there is an underwater explosion. What is the effect of underwater explosion on the ship structure? Actually, it is not the explosion that creates damage. It is the generated shockwave that creates this severe structural damage, which is very important for the safety of crew members. We were able to simulate, we were able to understand what is happening in these extreme cases. For this purpose, we use composite materials. And analyzing composite materials for damage evaluation is very complex. But paradynamics did a very good job in predicting these damage patterns. Another challenge that ship structures are exposed to is global warming. Due to global warming, the ice in the Arctic Ocean start melting, start shrinking. And now shipping companies are looking for solutions. They are saying that in order to go from far east to Europe, they are deciding to go from Arctic Ocean, because it is much shorter than the shipping route from Indian Ocean and Suez Canal. That's a good idea, but it brings additional challenges, which is ice. Everybody knows about Titanic accident. The ship sank after striking to an iceberg. So if we don't design our ships that can handle these ice impacts, and if such an incident occurs, we can have severe structural damages. Therefore, we need to design ships that can resist these ice impacts. To make this, we again use fair dynamics. We simulated ice as a material, ship as a material, and tried to understand what happens if these two structures are hitting to each other. Here you can see a structure is hitting to an ice sheet. You can see radial cracks and circumferential cracks. And we were able to simulate these crack patterns by using pair dynamics. So this methodology again can help us for designing future ships that can resist such impacts. As you see, we can investigate many different cracking problems by using pair dynamics. For this reason, we established world's first research center on pair dynamics here at University of Strathclyde. And we are hoping that we will continue working on many more different cracking problems. Thank you very much for your attention.